You're intelligent young people. You're obviously seeking the truth. I wish the best for you. I want you to critically think, not just okay blindly. If you look at Judas, what happened to Judas? We have here in Acts 1:18. Now this man, Judas, purchased a field with his wages that he had earned from betraying Jesus of iniquity. Wait, and falling. Go ahead.
Sorry.
I'm sorry.
Judas returned the money that he got.
Okay, so this is exactly the point. That is a contradiction. So here he fell headlong and burst open the middle of his, and his entrails gushed out. Okay? The same Judas in the same New Testament here, if we find now in Matthew, then he threw down the pieces of silver in the temple, as you had said, departed and went and hunged himself. So you see, there's two different accounts of what happened to Judas. One, that he took that money, bought a piece of land and fell in it and his guts spilt out, and the other that he threw that money back and hung himself.
And that's two different people that said that, correct? Like,
yes.
One person saying this and another person said
yes.
The other thing.
Excellent. So yeah, this means this is not the word of God. This is people's accounts that can differ and have errors. We agree that this is not the word of God. This is people's account that can have errors.
It is the word of God, but people wrote it.
Well, I have one thing to say.
So
about
are
that.
There errors though? Because one, it has to be one or the other, right? It couldn't be.
There's errors.
But you just saw it.
Are you familiar with like just in general, like court and just criminal justice? And,
yes.
And, okay.
So let me just answer that if you don't mind.
Okay.
In court, people testify, right. Not God, and those people have mistakes. Somebody will be right. Somebody will be wrong. So if you're saying that this is the testimony like people in court, then this is not the word of God. This has errors because people error. When two people testify, one says he did it and one says he didn't, one of them has to be right. So either Judas, as you said, threw the money back and hung himself, or he kept the money, bought land and fell and his guts fell out. It can't be both. So one of them is wrong. So this means this that you're making the criteria for right and wrong definitely has errors. Parts of this Bible is the opinions of people that is error. We agree on that now.
Yes.
Thank you.
Because
he agreed at least.
People are people.
They make mistakes.
Exactly. But you have
give
to,
me that, bro. Give
one,
me that.
One thing you have to understand, because you're missing the point of what I'm saying.
I don't think I am,
because,
but okay.
Because if all of the stories match up perfectly, it's suspect in the court system, right?
Right. Because
so it makes more perfect sense that all of the stories are different because they're all from different perspectives.
Excellent. So this is the perspectives of people.
Different people from different perspectives.
Yes. Thank you.
That's why they're saying different things, because they weren't all at the same spot at the exact same time, writing down the same thing.
I'm in agreement.
Their lives in different places, and they all had different experiences at
excellent.
Different times of Jesus.
And some of them are wrong.
Right.
Right. So some of this Bible is wrong.
Depending on the event.
But there are wrong things in it, because he just said it's a perspective of people, right?
Right.
He agreed now, so at least he's on the same page.
Let me put it this way, because now you're cutting me off a little bit.
I'm not, I'm listening.
Let me try to put it this way.
Okay.
For example, let's say I'm standing on way over there on that side of the courtyard.
Mm-hmm.
You're standing here, and she's standing way on that side.
Okay.
And right here in the middle, in between all of us,
yes.
Somebody gets stabbed, right?
Gotcha.
And we all give an account to a police officer of what happened.
They're going to differ.
We're all going to give a different perspective because we're all different people in different places experiencing the same thing at a different time.
Excellent.
So that's exactly why the accounts differ.
So I'm not missing that point. Uh-huh. I'm actually agreeing to it.
Okay.
And here in the Bible, we see different accounts, so some of them are wrong. So there are errors here from people's perspectives.
But the point that you're missing
can
is
can I finish?
It all has the
I'll let you finish.
Yeah,
right?
But it's all the same story.
I'm going to listen to
it's
him.
It's all the
then.
Same story. All the points connect. Mm-hmm. Even though it's a different account and different perspective, as long as it's the big, it's the bigger picture that matters, is what I'm saying.
I'm letting you finish.
Yeah.
So when you have errors, then it cannot be considered the word of God, because you earlier agreed that God is perfect. He doesn't make errors. So the issue gets to be, now that you know there are different perspectives and errors, this cannot become our criteria for right and wrong, because it obviously has mistakes. Now I'm going to make an assertion to you that we have the Quran with no errors. Zero. The words of God, not the words of men, not perspective, not what I saw and what he saw, and no errors in it. So why don't we make that the criteria of right and wrong, that which zero errors?